Good morning, Andy. In this class, we will discuss about the power transistors. Before going to power transistors, what is meant by power diodes? Power diodes are uncontrolled devices. In other words, their turn on and turn off characteristics are not under our control. But power transistors, however, possess controlled characteristics. These are turned on when a current signal is given to the base or control terminal. The transistor remains in the on state so long as the control signal is present. So when this control signal is removed, the power transistor is turned off. So coming to power transistors, these are of the four types. That means first one is bipolar junction transistors, metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor is the second one, and insulated gate bipolar transistor is the third one, and static induction transistors are the fourth one. That means coming to here, there will be of the power transistors are the four types. First one is BJT. And second one is MOSFET. Third one is IGBT. Fourth one is SIT. Coming to this one here, the symbol is of the bipolar junction transistor is like that. That means they are the three terminals will be the emitter, base, collector, and the symbol is like this. So this is the PNP transistor and this one will be the NPN transistor. In which way you can remember means here the arrow mark is outside, so that's why it is a NPN transistor. If the arrow mark is inside, then it will be the PNP transistor, you can remember. And next, basically BJT will be of the two types, that is NPN and PNP transistor. Here we are considering generally NPN transistor we are considering at present for our discussion. And BJT has three terminals, that is collector, emitter and base. And emitter is indicated by an arrow direction, where this arrow means it will indicate the direction of the emitter current. And of course there will be of the no arrow at the base or collector. Please remember this one. And of course power transistors of the NPN type are also easy to manufacture and cheaper also. And here therefore the use of the power NPN transistors is very wide in the high voltage and high current applications. Coming to the next topic is steady state characteristics. Okay, steady state characteristics. In the case of the steady state characteristics, we will go for first one is input characteristics. Their VB will be the input and VCC will be the output, and VBE is the input voltage and IB is the input current, and VCE will be the output current and output voltage, and IC will be the output current. So here coming to input characteristics. Okay, coming to input characteristics are nothing but here you can observe in this input characteristics the characteristics between the base current and VBE, okay, base current and VBE, whereas the characteristics of the VCE1, and that means output voltage is putting as a constant, and here the variation between the input voltage VBE and IB we are going to calculate, that will be the input characteristics. And that means here you can observe that VCE1, first case you will put one VCE1 value, and next you will take the readings of the IB and VBE. And next one VCE2 also we will take something constant, and then also you can observe the IB and VBE value. Those will be called as the input characteristics. Similar to the input characteristics, here you can observe the output characteristics also. Here for the case of the output characteristics, you can observe what are the output characteristics? Output characteristics are the characteristics between the output current IC versus VCE output voltage. And here you can observe that cutoff region is below between the IB is equal to 0, and there will be of the leakage current you can observe, and the saturation region also you can observe in the by means of the our diagram. So here these are the output characteristics. Here clearly, particularly, that means whenever for the case of the output characteristics, here what is the constant? IB is equal to constant. That means input current. Input current is equal to constant. That means if you are taking the input characteristics IB versus VBE, then output voltage VCE will be the constant. If you are taking the output characteristics IC versus VCE, then input current will be the constant, that is IB is equal to constant. So please be remember these two points. Coming to this portion here, what you can observe is for IB is equal to 0, that means cos 1 for IB is equal to 0 he is mentioning, and next for IB not is equal to 0 he is mentioning. That means the initial part of the curve is characterized by the low VCE, is called saturation region. Okay, low VCE, which is called saturation region. In this region, the transistor acts like a switch. That means the flat part of the curve 2, here you can observe the flat part, that flat part which is indicated by the increasing the VCE value and almost constant IC is the active region you can observe in the diagram. In this region, transistor is acts like an amplifier. That means here, for the first region, in the case of the saturation region, your transistor is acting like a switch. For the case of the active region, the transistor will be like active work as a amplifier. Almost vertically rising curve is a breakdown region which must be avoided at all costs. That means there will be of the three regions will be there. First one is saturation region, second one is active region, and third one is a breakdown region. Here you can observe. That means in the case of the saturation region, it is acting as a switch. In the case of the active region, it is acting as a amplifier. And here breakdown region, it won't work. So here you should avoid this breakdown region. For the case of the IC value, what is the IC formula here? IC is equal to VCC minus VCE divided by RC. So here you can observe that formula. IC is equal to VCC minus, that means total output voltage minus VCC minus VCE divided by RC you can get. Alpha is equal to forward current gain. Alpha is equal to IC divided by IE, which can be called as, okay, alpha is equal to IC divided by IE, which can be called as the forward current gain. The range of the alpha is equal to 0.952, okay, 0.952, 0.99, and beta is equal to ratio of the IC to the IB, which will be having the value is more than the unity, okay, more than unity, which will be having the value, and approximate value is equal to 50 to the 300, which will be having the beta value. So please remember this one. And of course, when alpha is equal to beta divided by 1 plus beta is the one formula you need to remember, and beta is equal to alpha divided by 1 minus alpha also you need to remember. Please remember that. Here these are the two relations between the alpha and beta. So coming to the next one, this is exclusively about our power transistor. And the next one is, here we are going for the power MOSFET, okay, power MOSFET and power IGBT. Here this is the exclusively simple case of the our power BJT. Here this is the symbol of the power MOSFET. Okay, power MOSFET can also be called as a metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor. Here you can remember that there are three terminals. Okay, power MOSFET has the three terminals. You can observe in the diagram, power MOSFET will be having the three terminals. Those three terminals can be called as the drain, source, gate. Okay, those three terminals can be called as the drain, source, gate. And of course, which are similar to the collector, emitter, base. Okay, drain is equivalent to the collector, and source is equivalent to the emitter, and gate is equivalent to the base. Please remember this one. And here also the arrow indicates the direction of the electrons flow. And whereas the differences, coming to the differences between the our BJT and MOSFET, here BJT is a, first point is BJT is a current controlled device. Okay, BJT is a current controlled device, whereas MOSFET is a voltage controlled device. Please remember this one. Here in the case of the BJT, the conduction is due to the both majority and minority carriers. In the case of the MOSFET, the conduction due to the only majority carriers. So that's why here BJT can be called as a bipolar device, and MOSFET can be called as a unipolar device. And next one you need to remember is, here the control signal or base current in BJT is very high. The fourth point you need to remember is control current or base current is very high in the case of the BJT, whereas in the MOSFET IB, that means control current or base current will be is less, and which is nothing but there is a large impedance in the case of the MOSFET. MOSFET low, in the case of the MOSFET there is a large impedance. Okay, there is a large impedance. Impedance will be large, but in the case of the BJT there is a small impedance you can get. Okay, you can get there is a small impedance. So these are the basic differences between this power MOSFET. And here you are seeing this will be called as a n-channel enhancement MOSFET. Okay, n-channel enhancement MOSFET. And of course these MOSFET, power MOSFET, are of the two types. First one is n-channel enhancement MOSFET, and of course p-channel also will be there. Here there is a some construction type will be there, what we will see now. So here you can observe in the diagram, on p substrate two heavily doped n plus regions are diffused as shown, and insulating layer of the silicon dioxide is grown on the surface. Now this insulating layer is etched in order to embed metallic source and drain terminals. That means here on the p substrate you are observing, on this p substrate two n plus regions are there, and of course silicon dioxide are there, on that one it will be etched. So that's why here you can place a source and drain. Okay, these are the basic construction. And of course a layer of the metal is also deposited on SiO2 layer so as to form the gate of the MOSFET in between the source and drain terminals. Okay, in between the source and drain terminals you are observing a layer of the metal also is also deposited on SiO2, you can observe. So in order to form the gate. Next, so what is the operation? Okay, this is the construction point of view. And what is the operation? When the gate circuit is open, okay, when the gate circuit is open, so here if the gate circuit is open, junction between the n plus region below the drain and p substrate is reverse biased by input voltage VDD. So if the gate circuit is open, the junction between the n plus region below the drain and p substrate is reverse biased by input voltage VDD. Therefore no current flows from the drain to the source and the load. So whenever, next point is you need to observe, when the gate is made positive with respect to the source, then what is happening? An electric field is established between them. Then automatically induced negative charges in the p substrate below the SiO2 layer are formed, thus causing the p layer below the gate to become an induced n layer. These negative charges are called electrons, form n channel between two n plus regions. That means if the circuit is forward biased, then there will be of the electric field will be formed. So due to that electric field there will be of the flow of the electrons between the two n plus regions, and current can flow from the drain to source as shown by the arrow. That means from the drain to source there will be of the current will be flowing. If VGS is more positive, that means gate to source voltage is more positive, induced n channel becomes more deep and more current will be flowing from the drain to source. This shows that the drain current ID is enhanced by gradual increase of gate voltage. So that's why, just because of this reason, it is having the name of the enhancement MOSFET. Once again I am repeating, here if VGS is made more positive, that means gate to source voltage is made more positive, then induced n channel becomes more deep and therefore more current flows from the drain to source. This shows that the drain current ID is enhanced by gradual increase of the gate voltage, hence the name is called enhancement MOSFET. Here there will be of the large on state resistance will be there, so that's why there will be of the large power loss also will be there. So that's why in order to avoid this power loss, we'll go for next one is, which is nothing but the n channel DMOS power MOSFET. So we will see next one is n channel DMOS power MOSFET. Here this is the n channel DMOSFET power MOSFET. This is also same as it is of the previous one, but slight changes are there, we will see now. Here the same construction, on n place substrate a high resistivity n minus layer, okay, on n place substrate high resistivity n minus layer is epitaxially grown. The thickness of the n minus layer determines the voltage blocking capability of the device. On the other side of the n place substrate, a metal layer is deposited to form the drain terminal. Now p regions are diffused in the epitaxially grown n minus layer. Further, n plus regions are diffused in p source and gate terminals. A power MOSFET is actually consists of a parallel connection of thousands of the basic power MOSFET cells. That means here you can observe by the diagram on the n plus substrate. Okay, on the n plus substrate, what he is doing is a high resistivity n minus layer is epitaxially run. That means n minus layer you can observe in the diagram. And the thickness of the n minus layer determines, the thickness of that layer determines the voltage blocking capability of the device. On the other side of this n plus substrate, a metal layer is also deposited to form the drain terminal. There is a drain terminal is also forming. You can observe here in the diagram, drain terminal is forming. And next, further n plus regions, okay, n plus regions are also diffused in the p regions. When the here what is the operation, when the gate circuit voltage is zero, then VDD is present, then automatically n minus p minus junctions are reverse bias, no current will be flowing from the drain to source. But when the gate terminal is made positive with respect to the source, an electric field is established and electrons from the n channel in the p regions as shown, so current will be flowing from the drain to the source is indicated. This is the operation of the our DMOS power MOSFET. So next one is here, these are the power MOSFET in general. This is the power MOSFET circuit diagram. You can observe gate to source voltage, you can observe drain to source voltage, you can observe ID also, you can observe. This is the circuit diagram. Okay, after the circuit diagram, next we are going for the typical transfer characteristics. Here these are the typical transfer characteristics. Here this characteristics will show, what it will show means the threshold voltage. You can observe the threshold voltage VGST. It is nothing but here it is the minimum amount of the positive voltage between gate and source to induce n channel. Please remember this one. What is by VGST? VGST is the minimum positive voltage between gate and source to induce n channel. That is the threshold voltage. That means here threshold voltage is below the VGST, the device is in the off state. Next, output characteristics. That means your voltage below the threshold, below the VGST, your MOSFET will not work. Above the VGST only your MOSFET works. So here these are the characteristics between the gate to source voltage and the drain current. Next one, here you can observe the next characteristics are here. These characteristics are the output characteristics. Just we have observed in the case of the power BJT. Here also ohmic region will be there, which is nothing but saturation region, active region will be there, and of course breakdown region also will be there. Here in which way you can observe means here there is a flat, okay, there is a flat characteristics will be there. That flat characteristics can be taken as the active region. And before that one region will be there, that region can be taken as the ohmic region, which is nothing but here in the case of the ohmic region, what are the characteristics here? The current, the output characteristics here is the characteristics between the drain current and VDS, okay, drain current and VDS, drain to source voltage and drain current you can take here. With gate to source voltage is as a parameter for lower values of the VDS. Here you can observe in the diagram, for lower values of the VDS, the graph is almost linear. Okay, thus indicates the constant value of the resistance or DS is equal to VDS divided by ID. And VDS is increased, the output characteristic is relatively flat. which is indicate it is the active region, which is nothing but almost constant. And of course, there is a load line which is intersecting between the output characters of the A and B. You can observe here A indicates fully on condition and here B indicates fully off state condition. That means P MOSFET operates as a switch either at A or B, just like a BJT. When the power MOSFET is driven with large gate to source voltage, MOSFET is turned on and next VDS is on. VDS is small, this MOSFET is acting as a closed switch. So this is the these are the basic characteristics of the basic characteristics, same characteristics and even Niguda. Here these characteristics can be called as the output characteristics. Okay, here output characteristics are between these two, means ID versus VDS is called the output characteristics. Okay, ID versus VGS is called the transfer characteristics. Please remember that one. Transfer characteristics are nothing but ID versus VGS. Output characteristics are nothing but ID versus VDS. Okay, those are the output characteristics. And coming to this one here, these are the switching characteristics. Switching characteristics you can observe, which is nothing but just like to our similar to the power MOSFET also, power BJT also. Here you can observe turn on delay time will be there, and in next turn on delay time, that means there is a slight delay will be there, turn on delay time, and next there will be of the fall time also will be there. These are the characteristics. And next one here, the comparison between before going to the IGBT, here the comparison between power MOSFET and BJT. Once again I will repeat, here BJT is a bipolar device. Okay, BJT is a bipolar device and MOSFET is a unipolar device. Here MOSFET is a unipolar device, BJT is a bipolar device. And so power MOSFET will be having the higher input impedance and all these characteristics you have listened. Okay, first one is one more, still some more characteristics are there, means P MOSFET will be having the higher voltage ratings and more conduction loss. P MOSFET is having the higher voltage ratings and more conduction loss. And next here, P MOSFET will be having the positive temperature coefficient of resistance. Please remember this one. And next, P MOSFETs are available between 500 volts to 140 amperes, whereas BJT are available 1200 volts and 800 amperes. Okay, 800 amperes they will get. Here you can observe these two things. So in addition to the points we have discussed earlier. So there we have discussed that BJT is a bipolar device, MOSFET is a unipolar device. MOSFET is a high input impedance will be having, the BJT is a low input impedance, and MOSFET will be having the lowest switching losses. Okay, MOSFET here, this is the one more important point. MOSFET is having the lower switching losses. Okay, lower switching losses, but it on state and conduction losses are more. Okay, conduction losses are more. Please remember this one. The opposite case for this one, BJT will be having the higher switching losses. Okay, BJT will be having the higher switching losses, but lower conduction losses. Okay, but lower conduction losses. Lower conduction loss and higher switching loss is for BJT. The opposite case is for our MOSFET. These are the basic discussion about our BJT and our MOSFET. So next one is IGBT. Okay, next one is IGBT. Here we will discuss now. So coming to IGBT. Okay, coming to IGBT here, this is the structure. Okay, this is the structure which is very similar to the, okay, here this is the structure very similar to the our power MOSFET only, but slight difference is there. Here in the case of the IGBT, one more thing you need to remember is IGBT is also known as the metal oxide insulated gate transistor and conductively modulated field effect transistor and gain modulated field effect transistor and insulated gate transistor. That means the other names of the IGBT are, once again I am repeating, metal oxide insulated gate transistor and conductively modulated field effect transistor and gain modulated field effect transistor and insulated gate transistor. Here IGBT, coming to the construction, IGBT P plus substrate is called injection layer. Here you can observe that P plus substrate, you can observe by means of diagram. It is called as the injection layer because it injects holes into the N minus layer. This N minus layer is called as the drift region. As in other semiconductor device, the thickness of the N minus layer determines the voltage blocking capability of IGBT. And next, here the P layer is called as the body of the IGBT, and N minus layer is between the P plus and P regions to serve to accommodate the depletion layer of the P N minus junction. That means here the N minus layer is between the P plus and P region, so which is to serve the depletion layer of the PN junction. You need to remember that is the construction of the our IGBT. Next, equivalent circuit. Okay, coming to the equivalent circuit is, yeah, this is the equivalent circuit of the our IGBT. That means here IGBT can be thought of the two combination of the MOSFET and our power BJT. MOSFET and power BJT, the combination is nothing but our this one. Here you can observe the diagram. This is the equivalent circuit. Here also this is the approximate equivalent circuit, which in other words the combination of the MOSFET and BJT can be called as the IGBT. So that's why here this is the symbol is like this. Here you can observe this is the symbol. Okay, this is the symbol you can observe. That means this is the basic circuit diagram and exact equivalent circuit. And of course the what is the symbol here, this is the symbol you can observe. This is the IGBT symbol, just like the same as it is of the previous cases, but here the symbol is slight change. You can remember this one. Okay, and next one, coming to our IGBT characteristics. So here this is the circuit diagram of the static IV characteristics. Okay, static IV characteristics. So before going to static IV characteristics, here in which way this function will be occurring means, whenever the collector is made positive with respect to the emitter, IGBT gets forward biased with no voltage between the gate and emitter, two junctions between N minus region and P region are reverse biased. So no current will be flowing from the collector to emitter. When the gate made positive with respect to the emitter by means of VG, with gate to emitter voltage more than the threshold voltage of the IGBT, an N channel or inversion layer will be formed. So in this way our power IGBT will be working. And the next one is, here this is the circuit. Okay, this is the circuit of the IGBT. Basic circuit diagram of the IGBT is here. And next, coming to the what are the characteristics, the static IV characteristics we will see. Here these are the static IV characteristics. In the case of the static IV characteristics, that means the characteristics between the collector current and collector to emitter voltage, here you can observe. Here this is the similar to the same case of the power MOSFET. And next one is, here this is also you can observe, this characteristic can be called as the transfer characteristics. Okay, this can be called as the transfer characteristics, just like the VGST. Here also VGET will be there. So which are the both are the same as it is case of the power MOSFET. And coming to what are the application, here these are the switching characteristics. Okay, here these are the switching characteristics, so you can remember. And next, what are the applications of the IGBT? Here the application of the IGBT are nothing but in the case of the DC and motor drives we will use. Okay, but the applications are in the case of the DC and AC motor drives, and of course UPS systems and power supplies and drives for solenoids. Okay, drives for solenoids also we will use. And in the case of the relays and contactors also, this power switching device you will be using. And IGBT will be having the 15 to 20 kilohertz range will be there. And what are the differences between the comparison between the this comparison between the this IGBT and power MOSFET is nothing but power MOSFET will be having the three terminals. What are those three terminals? Gate, source and drain. Here coming to IGBT, also gate, emitter, collector, these are the three terminals. And both IGBT and power MOSFET will be having the higher input impedance, okay, higher input impedance. And of course these two are both are voltage controlled devices, okay, both are voltage controlled devices. And of course if with the rise in the temperature, with the rise in the temperature, the increase in the on state resistance in the P MOSFET is much more than the IGBT. So on state voltage drop and losses rise rapidly in the P MOSFET, okay, P MOSFET losses anedi ekkuntundi P MOSFET than IGBT with rise in the temperature. And with rise in the voltage rating, okay, with the rise in the voltage rating, the increment in on the on state voltage drop is more predominant in the P MOSFET than and in the IGBT. That means IGBT can be designed for higher voltage ratings. So please remember this point. IGBT can be designed for higher voltage ratings than power MOSFET. And P MOSFETs, okay, P MOSFETs are available up to 500 volts to 140 amperes, but here IGBT, okay, but here IGBT are 1200 volts and 500 amperes, okay, 1200 volts and 500 amperes. Whatever the frequency, power MOSFETs are operating up to 1 megahertz, but here the frequency in the case of the IGBT 50 kilohertz. Here these are the basic power transistors of the our general power electronics.